Greetings, people. Paul Muckle here. Today is July 16, 2013 at 10:16 p.m. Eastern Time. Good news, my friends. Good news. The warrant has been recalled. As you all can tell in my voice, I'm tired, exhausted. What a spiritual battle I had to fight today. Anyway, people, as you all know, right, those of you who've been vigilant for me and paying attention, I uploaded this video this morning telling you guys that I was headed to jail because I had a suspicion that these people were going to put an arrest warrant out for me. Because people, those of you who haven't seen the video, yesterday around 2 o'clock in the morning, I got a call from the GPS monitor service saying that my GPS, it had malfunctioned and if I was tampering with it, I said no. So they told me, well, I have to call my PO in the morning and get a new strap on it because it was malfunctioning. In the morning, when I woke up, I did it. Called my PO, left him a message. He never returned my call. I got in touch with my attorney. My attorney tried to get in touch with him. He never returned my attorney call either. So people, I go outside and to talk to my friend, and my door pin another eviction notice. Yesterday, July 15th, they pinned another eviction notice on my door. But this time I have to go to court. So, I came upstairs and I'm like, what the heck's going on here? Last time my bracelet malfunctioned, now I'm getting an eviction notice. So, my attorney told me to send him an email to detailing how come this bracelet is always malfunctioning. So people are going to internet to send my attorney an email, and I found out that my email account had, I found out that I sent an email to the weasel. And as you guys know, I have a restraining, he has a restraining order against me not to contact him. So anyway, I found that I sent him an email. But I'm like, what the heck? Why would I send this guy an email? So I went and checked and found out that my email account had been hacked. So now people, you see now, my GPS malfunction, my email hacked, and I get an eviction notice. And all three are related to the weasel. The weasel is the one who filed a criminal complaint against me, said I threatened to kill him, stalk him, harass him. He's the one who got the GPS on my ankle, and he's the one trying to evict me. And I have a court order not to send me any emails. So the same thing that happened last year, it's like the same thing they're doing to me this year again, setting me up. We gotta get ready to try to take my house again. So now, they're trying to get me locked up. And that's my suspicion. Because it's too coincidental. Either that people are, my God is confusing them. My God is bringing evidence against them. Because now, this looks so suspicious. Anyone who look at this now gonna know that they did it. So if they didn't do it, I didn't do it. So that means my God is setting them up. Because no, they cannot deny it. They can never deny they didn't do this. Because who else would do it? Why would I hack my own email account? And why would I send this weasel emails when I know I could go to jail for it? And why would I tamper with the GPS bracelet when I know I'll go and get into trouble with it for it? So is this weasel trying to threaten and intimidate me? And I already made up my mind, the one in the house that could take it. You won't put me in jail, go and put me in jail. Because guess what? Him who fights and runs away, live to fight another day. You never, ever gonna convict me on anything, number one. And number two, my civil case against you is going to a jury trial. So you could take my house. I'm gonna use your money and buy 10 more. Okay? So, anyway, the point being, people, is that the warrant has been recalled. Wow, huh? All this time yesterday, I make this video telling you guys that I suspect they're going to lock me up. And truth to the word, while I'm making the video, there was an active warrant out for me. This warrant was issued, people, on July 15, 2013. So since yesterday, they had a warrant out for me. Notice of recall of warrant. Paul Muckle, date warrant issued, 7/15/2013. Date what we called. To the defendant name above, you are hereby notified that the court has recalled without service and canceled the warrant against you that is listed above. This recall notice applies only to the warrant listed above, which was issued and recalled on the dates listed above. It does not apply to any subsequent warrant issued under the same case docket numbers. So people, I don't know if they're planning something else, but anyway, the warrant had been recalled. What happened was, this morning, when I woke up, I called the GPS monitor service to ask them what was up, and they say, "What, you haven't you called your PO?" And I said, "I can't get in touch with him." He said, well, you need to go to the court. I said, "Why?" He said, "Because there's a warrant out for your arrest." So he said, "Go down there quick, try to take care of it before they come and get you." So I called my attorney quickly and notified him. He said he was at a jury trial. He was in jury duty, but he wants what he could do. So I called and I finally got in touch with the PO, and he confirmed that he had a warrant out for my arrest. And he said, "You better get down to the court to clear it up." He said, "Where you at?" I said, "I'm home. I've been home all since yesterday." I said, "I put myself under house arrest because I knew your guy was up to something." So he said, "I put myself under house arrest. I didn't go any place, so y'all can't suspect me." So he said, "Well, you need to get down here." So my attorney texted me and he said, "I spoke to him and he gonna put a new bracelet on your leg. And if he's not there, his assistant gonna help him." But people, I didn't trust them still. I said, they're up to something. They're up to no good. So I didn't really trust them that they're not going to hold on to me for something else. But, you know, I trusted my Lord. I trusted Rara. And I trusted the Creator. So, I had faith, even though I packed up most of my paperwork and said some goodbyes, but I had faith, you know, and I trust. Rara, if it's your will for me to go to jail, I'm going to go. If it's not your will, no one could put me in jail. So I went, you know, with my faith intact. And I was willing, people. I was willing to give up my freedom, to stand up for my rights, let them do what they want to do to me, because in the end, I'm going to be victorious. So people, this is what they do. How do they make us afraid? They threaten us, "Oh, we're going to lock you up," and we submit to them. They threaten, "Oh, I'm going to take your house," and we submit to them. So guess what? I'm willing to give up my freedom. I'm willing to give up the house so that you won't use it as a weapon against me. You're not going to use my freedom to make me give up my fight against you. You're not going to use my house to make me give up my fight against you. There's nothing you're going to use. You have tried everything, and it has all failed. So the only thing I fear was to lose my freedom and to be homeless. But now, I'm going to give up those burdens. Those are two burdens that are holding me down. They're keeping me from flying, from ascending. The house and my freedom are keeping me from ascending. And when I say freedom, I mean my physical freedom. It's keeping me from ascending. So if I want to ascend, I have to let them go. So you could have them Illuminati government. You could have my body. You could have my material possession. But you will never get my soul. Never. You will never get my mind either. Those are the two things you want, and you will not get them. Because as long as I have my mind intact and my soul intact, I shall fear no evil. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For whoever is with me, his rod and his staff, they comfort me. He prepared a table before me in the presence of my enemies. He anointed my head with oil. My cup went over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Okay, so what can you all do to me? I fear you not. So I thank those of my friends who stood vigil You know, those of you who didn't know about it, I know if you all knew, you all would have been vigilant also. So, much respect. Victorious, you know. There's only one thing for me, you know. Death or victory. And I'm not afraid of death. So, I know I'm going to get victory. Okay? Because I have also defeated the fear of death. I do not fear death. So, you cannot scare me with death. Okay? So, there you go. I defeated death. I've defeated the love of my physical freedom. And I've defeated my material possession. Okay? Alright, so one love, one heart, one destiny to all humanity. And to paraphrase my good friend Patrick Henry, should I keep back my opinion at such a time to fear of giving offense? I should consider myself guilty of treason towards my planet Earth and an act of disloyalty towards the majesty of heaven, who I revere above all earthly kings.